Good morning, students. This is Economics Standard 12, Chapter number 5, continuation, topic number 5.3, that is Indicators of Poverty. Okay, I hope आपने बाकी के जो दो हैं वीडियो हैं वो देख लिए होंगे और आप ये तीसरा देख रहे हैं, right? तो please keep on watching और अगर आपको पसंद आए तो please share और subscribe करो. So that हम आपके पास आपके जैसे बच्चों को और मदद कर सकें. Okay, let's start. Indicators of poverty. Now the level of ये पहले बात बता देता हूँ कि indicators of poverty very important question, right? ये बहुत जरूरी है. इसका आप अगर लिखेंगे अच्छी तरह लिखेंगे तो आप पूरे 4 marks मिलेंगे. Okay, 5 marks मिलेंगे. आपका 5 marks का question में आएगा तो please ध्यान रखना 5 marks और 3 marks में इसको पूछ सकते हैं. Okay, let's start. Indicators of poverty. The level of poverty and the components are called its indicators. Barabar. The level of poverty and their components are called its indicators. In our country, there are many factors showing poverty are known as its indicator. Indicators are useful to know to prove the poor levels of the poverty. With this, we know that the nature and the measurement of poverty. The level of poverty and their components are called its indicators. In our country, various factors showing poverty are known as its indicator. Indicators are useful to know the poverty and levels of poverty. With this, we can know the nature and measurement of poverty. The indicators of poverty are as follows. Number one, per capita household consumption expenditure. जब हम लोग ने absolute में देखा था, right? तो per capita household consumption expenditure. Per capita household expenditure is the amount of income a family spends on an average on consumption of goods and services. It is calculated at the market price of durable goods like cars, washing machines, computers and so on. The nation's total spending on such goods is divided by the total population to calculate this. The per capita consumption expenditure for developing countries is much lower than that of the developed countries, and in this sense, developing countries are poor. The following table shows the per capita consumption expenditure of many countries. आप ये देख सकते हैं fixed price of 2005 in US dollar year 2014 per capita consumption expenditure. US का कितना है 31,469, UK का 25,828, Japan का 22,149, Pakistan का 603, China का 1,420 और हमारा India का consumption है 725. Okay, so comparatively where we are, you can understand. Now, according to the above information, on the basis of the base year of the 2005, in the year 2014, as per capita, household consumption expenditure was 725 in India and 31,469 in US, 25,828 in UK, $22,149 in Japan, and $603 in Pakistan. Per capita household consumption expenditure is very less in India as compared to US and UK. Level of malnutrition, right? Malnutrition, ये वर्ड आ रहा है ना, उसकी deficiency को बोलते हैं malnutrition. Malnutrition is a such a situation in which the food taken by individual lack calories like proteins, carbohydrates, vitamins and minerals. In India, in spite of an increase in agricultural production, people with low income are unable to get nutritive food. ये वाला वर्ड याद रखो, nutritive food, because of low per capita income and the unequal distribution of income. India's information regarding the people with malnutrition is as follows. ये total malnourished people में और यहाँ पे year दिया है 90 to 92, 23.7, 2000 to 2002 17.5, 5 to 7 में 20.5, 10 to 12 में 15.6 और 14 to 16 में कितना है 15.2. तो सोर्स देखो, यहाँ पे हर एक में हमेशा सोर्स दिया जाता है. सोर्स इसलिए देते हैं कि उसका रिलायबिलिटी कितना है, उसका वैलिडिटी, उसका ऑथेंटिसिटी बोलते ना वो, ये जो है. तो दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट, हम लोगों ने स्टेटिस्टिक्स में पढ़ा है, राइट? तो अकॉर्डिंग टू द अबाउट टेबल, इन द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ 1992, इंडिया है total of 23.7% of the malnourished people. Likewise, in the year 2002 to 2005 to 7 and 10 to 12, it is 17.5, 20.5 and 15.6% of malnourished population respectively. According to FAO, right, 2015, the report, the situation of food security in India, India ranked second in the world in measurement of malnourishment, which indicates poverty in India, right? So, बहुत important है ये. Next, life expectancy and infant mortality rate. Life expectancy, ये क्या होता है? Average life क्या चल रहा है? तो ये अगर हम average life देखें, तो आप देख ले सकते हैं कि जिस हमारे संसार गुरु के जो register हैं, जो है death rate जो है, वो find out करते हैं, उसका average निकालते हैं. उससे ये पता चलता है कि अभी कितने एज में लोग अभी मरते हैं, डेथ होती है. इन्फेंट मोर्टालिटी रेट, इन्फेंट मोर्टालिटी, इन्फेंट का मतलब ही है जो छोटा बच्चा बॉर्न हुआ है उसको इन्फेंट बोलते हैं. तो वन ईयर तक उसका जो है रजिस्टिंग पावर जो है, इम्यूनिटी है, वो कितना है, क्योंकि बाहर आते ही उसने उसको जो ओरिजिनल जो एनवायरमेंट है उसको फेस करना है, बहुत सारा एंटीबैक्टीरियल, वायरल, ये सब. तो ये जो इम्यूनिटी है उसको सर्वाइव करता है कि नहीं, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड इन्फेंट मोर्टालिटी रेट. तो अगर ये 1000 बच्चे में ये कितने बच्चे बचते हैं, कितने बच्चे मरते हैं, उसका एवरेज निकाला जाता है. तो लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी मीन्स दैट हाउ लॉन्ग न्यू बॉर्न बेबी इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू लिव ऑन एन एवरेज. द एवरेज लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी ऑफ पीपल इन अ कंट्री बेस्ड ऑन न्यूट्रिटिव फूड, क्लीनलीनेस, प्योर ड्रिंकिंग वाटर एंड हेल्थ सर्विसेज. पुअर पीपल आर डिप्राइव्ड ऑफ सच फैसिलिटीज, सो दे हैव हाउ लो लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी. Infant mortality means number of deaths taking place per 1000 children born before reaching the age of 1 year. ये इसका definition है, याद रखना. बराबर. The rate of infant mortality rate depends on the availability of health services, mothers' education, vaccination among children and nutrition of food. Infant mortality is also an indicator of poverty in respect to poor health services. The life expectancy and infant mortality rates of various countries of the world are shown below. देख लीजिए, life expectancy 2014, infant mortality. Norway में कितना है? 81.6, infant mortality only 2. Right? USA में 79.106, Sri Lanka में 74.909, China में 75.8, 10, India में 68 और 39. Right? So, according to the above information, in Norway, life expectancy is 81.6, America is 79.1, Sri Lanka is 74.9, China 75.8, whereas India is 68 years, which is even less than the China and Sri Lanka. In case of child mortality rate in Norway too, two children die per 1000, only two children. Superb, right? In America, 6, Sri Lanka 9, China 10, whereas in India, 39. Children die per 1000. Medical facilities. In the health sector, doctors, nurses, compounders, etc. are included, and their scarcity adversely affects health services. India, as compared to other countries, lacks medical services and doctors. In developing economies, people less medical services. They often suffer from various diseases as poor people do not get complete nutritive food. As a result, their immunity is too low. The country has less medical facilities. People are deprived of such services. As a result, poverty is more. In developing countries, every 6,000 population, one doctor is available, whereas among the developed economy, every 350 people service of one doctor. देखो कितना फर्क है. 6,000 के लिए एक डॉक्टर डेवलपिंग कंट्री में होता है, और यहाँ पे सिर्फ 350 लोगों के बीच में एक डॉक्टर. This is the difference between developed and developing. Okay. In developing countries, every year 1.7 crore people die from diarrhea, malaria and TB. In the whole world, 2.3 crore people are suffering from AIDS. Out of this, 90% people belong to developing economies. Next is drinking water. Health of population is very much connected to drinking water, right? इसको हम potable water भी बोलते हैं. And facilities of cleanliness. According to census report 2011, in India, 63.3% families get pure drinking water through treated sources. So what is treated sources? A government, municipality, jo usko cleaning karta hai, barabar process hai, cleaning process hai, that is called treated sources. 86.7% families get untreated tap water, direct water. And 26% people get water from other sources like well, hand pump, dew well, spring river, canal, pond, etc. In the absence of pure drinking water, polluted water increases the chances of having waterborne diseases and hence make the problem of poverty more severe. देखो ये indicators होते हैं, ये ऐसे components हैं जिसका effect से direct poverty मतलब economy को hurt होता है, right? So this all these things are to be taken care if we want to improve our economy. Now provision of toilet. According to the census report 2011 in India, 70% of total population lies in villages. They are more prone to waterborne and contagious diseases. To save them from diseases, cleanliness is very important, and for that, toilet facilities are must. Total families 100% to a toilet facility, 66%. A house without toilet facility, 34%. Abhi bhi log hain jo toilet facility bina rehte hain. In India, 66% houses have toilet facilities within house, whereas remaining 34% families use common toilets. Lack of cleanliness, pollution and physical weakness keep the production and the productivity at low level, which is one of the factors of rise in poverty. Next, housing, ghar, right? Roti, kapda aur makan. Makan kitna important hai, dekhi. One of the indicator of poverty is also housing facility and its nature. Developing countries lack housing facility. People live in dirty hutments and slums. This is called measurement of existing poverty. क्या बोलते हैं इसको? अगर आप झुपड़पट्टियाँ गिने, उससे हमको पता चल जाता है कि poverty कितना है. Housing is a primary need of human being. Types of housing facility decided the level of poverty. Construction of a house, veranda, members in the house, tap in the house, drainage, electricity facilities, etc. And percentage of houses with these facilities decides the level of poverty. India lacks houses with full facilities. In India, 60 crore people have dwellings which are dangerous for their health, right, and risky for their lives. बरोबर 60 करोड़ ऐसे जगह रहते हैं इनका घर इतना कच्चा घर होता है, कभी भी टूट सकता है, गिर सकता है, मतलब रिस्की लेवल पे, या तो फिर ऐसे बहुत ही झुपड़पट्टी जैसे में रहते हैं. Most of the houses in India comprise of one room facility, which is another major measuring rods of poverty. One room facility वाला सारा पूरा कुटुंब एक ही रूम में रहता है. Electricity consumption. One of the major factors in the development of any country is electric facility. To increase the production of country and quality of life of people, electricity is imperative, right? Very important. India is the main producer and consumer of electricity. So then also because of high population and low per capita income, per person electricity देखो है, जहाँ भी जाओ कुछ भी करो population हमको नजर आया है, right? क्योंकि उसके सामने वाला जो production है वो increase नहीं होता है, लेकिन population का जो production है वो increase होते जा रहा है. तो either you increase the opposite production or either you control the population, ये दोनों में से एक करना जरूरी है. Next है education. According to the World Bank, people in the age group of 15 years and above who can read and write are literate, and the rest are illiterate and they are mostly poor. देखो अभी literate का definition यहाँ पे जब लिखते हैं तभी आपको World Bank लिखना है, because literate का अलग अलग definition है. कोई जगह पे age standard तक भी बताया गया है, right? मतलब the age of 13 years तक, 7th और 8th तक पढ़े तो भी literate. तो you have to write according to the World Bank. The lack of education and training gives rise to the incapable and less productive laborers in the country. As a result, laborers get limited work opportunities and choices. Hence, less wages and low income increases poverty. In 2011, Brazil had 91% literacy rate, whereas in India, it was just 74.04%, Nepal 60% and 55% in Pakistan, which shows that in the developing country, the literacy rate is comparatively very less. Low education among poor makes them conservative and less acceptable to changes. High rate of ignorance is strong indicator of poverty. One line answer. High rate of death is a strong indicator, that is ignorant. Only level of per capita income cannot give the right estimate of poverty in the world. A country with a high per capita income can have high number of people below the poverty line also, right? America, a developed country, लेकिन अगर अभी भी कुछ लोग अगर वहाँ पे बहुत सारे beggars हैं तो फिर मतलब नहीं है उसको developed बोलने के लिए, right? This is what the difference is. Next, unequal distribution of income and property. After 1991, economic reforms, growth, economic growth and per capita income have increased sharply in India, but due to unequal distribution of income, larger reduction in poverty is noticed. Is not noticed. Larger reduction, distribution of income, larger reduction in poverty. ये क्या हो गया कि income जो है अगर equally बढ़ता है, income अगर जो government को मिल रहा है, ये पूरा nation का है, तो every citizen must get equally. लेकिन यहाँ ऐसा नहीं होता है, right? जो अमीर है उनको ज़्यादा जाता है, जो गरीब है उनको बहुत कम मिलता है. तो with the increase in the income inequality on one hand, we see rich class of people with high standard of living and enjoying good facilities, and on the other hand, we find low income people living in slums and deprived of basic necessities like food, education and health. The table below shows the actual income of top 1% rich class in USA, UK and India. देखो ये उसका national income of top 1%. US में 15.2 उनका share है और 2012 में उनका 18.9 हुआ. UK में 12.5 था तो फिर 12.7 हुआ. इंडिया का भी अच्छा ये 9 था, अभी हो गया 12.6. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दी अबाउ इंफॉर्मेशन इन कंपैरिजन टू 1998 एंड 2000, द टोटल रिच क्लास शेयर्स इन द एक्चुअल इनकम हैज इंक्रीज्ड इन कंपैरिजन टू 1998 इन द ईयर 2012. एक्चुअल नेशनल इनकम ऑफ टॉप 1% रिच क्लास इन US हैज इंक्रीज्ड फ्रॉम 15.2 टू 18.9 एंड UK 12.5 टू 12.7 and in India 9 to direct 12.6. For India, it can be said that the advantage from the economic reforms were more in favor of the rich. So the disparity of income inequality is also one of the indicators of gas. ये reforms जो आया था, जो क्या बोलते हैं industrial reforms जो आया है, ये right 1991 में यहाँ से start हुआ ज़्यादा inequality, right? तो high rate of unemployment when people with working capacity and willingness to work existing wage rate do not find work, they are said to be unemployed. This is definition of unemployment. Low economic development and jobless growth after 1991 resulted in the less development and less development of employment opportunities in comparison to increase in supply of labor is the main reason of increase in unemployment. In situation of unemployment due to lack of income, a person cannot fulfill basic needs of his family. सही बात है, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट होगा तो उसके पास इनकम नहीं होगा, इनकम नहीं होगा तो वो अपना बेसिक नीड्स अपना और अपने फैमिली का नहीं पूर्ति कर सकता है. एज अ रिजल्ट लेवल ऑफ पॉवर्टी रिमेंस हाई इन इंडिया टिल 2011 रेट ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट रिमेंड अराउंड 9%. अकॉर्डिंग टू द लेबर कमीशन इन द ईयर 2013-14 द रेट ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट अमंग पीपल 15 ईयर्स एंड अबव इज 4.9%. In rural area, this rate was 4.7% and in urban area, it was 5.5%, right? So this is how you have to go on. आपको ये important points सब याद रखने हैं. पहले तो आपको main points याद रखना है, 11 points है. फिर उसमें 11 points में जो कुछ important points है, उसको note कर लेना है. Then you can make paragraph of it, okay? I hope you understood. तो ये यहाँ हमारा ये indicators वाला topic खत्म हुआ. राइट, तो लेट्स मीट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. बाय टिल दैट, बाय. अगर आपको पसंद आए तो प्लीज़ शेयर और सब्सक्राइब करना. ओके, बाय फॉर द डे.